At HP, we are committed to creating a sustainable IT ecosystem by minimizing the destruction of natural resources. Cradle to cradle view means examining the energy required in extracting material, manufacturing, operating, and recycling or reclamation of our product.
Nanotechnology to flexible displays, so many people working on so many different kinds of things that you never run out of new things to think about.
It's very freeing and it's very exciting.
It's like rolling out a digital carpet onto a physical landscape. Possible because of location technology and the media that we can deliver to mobile gaming devices like this one. Imagine time traveling through the echoes of a city's history or turning it into a medieval world where magical experiences can be hidden around any corner. With GPS, a digital compass, and accelerometers, you can use a mobile device to virtually see what's behind the wall at any particular point.
Our job at HP Labs is to create the future for the Hewlett-Packard company.
Make big bets on things that could really pay off.
Solving real customer problems.
Making consumers happy.
Make a person's life easier.
We're here today to talk really about three things. Those three things are what's new at HP Labs, what and how important is R&D to the HP company, as well as looking at where we believe the IT industry is headed. I sort of like to believe that HP got its start as a lab, but that lab was a garage. So we like to believe that it all started there with two guys who were really basically looking at trying to solve the problems and solutions for that day and that time. This redesign is intended to do two things. And one, it's to balance exploratory research with this entrepreneurial approach to breakthrough technology. And it's going to allow us to more rapidly transfer this technology to the marketplace, to the end users, our customers. Well, I'm very pleased right now to introduce you to my colleague, Prith Banjeri, the director of HP Labs.
I arrived at HP Labs about 6 months ago, and I was handed a daunting challenge. Build a new blueprint for corporate research. We are going to refocus our effort in between 20 to 30 big bets, high impact research areas, away from these 150 or so smaller projects that we used to work on. We have established an internal review board consisting of HP's top technologists and business executives who will assist the researchers in transforming these scientific discoveries into the marketplace. The majority of the researchers are located right here in Palo Alto, but we have researchers in Bristol, Japan, China, India, Israel, and Russia. Collectively, these 600 researchers have hundreds of PhDs and they have thousands of patents, major research themes. They are information explosion, dynamic cloud services, content transformation, intelligent infrastructure, and sustainability. These five broad themes are going to be the focus of these 23 labs that I just talked to you, each of which will have 20 to 30 researchers. The first challenge I want to share with you is that of information explosion. I don't know if you know that the amount of information that we will create in the next 5 years is more the amount of information that has existed in the history of the planet. The next challenge is that of dynamic cloud services. By this I mean the next wave of services that individuals and businesses will access over the internet. Our researchers are working on technologies that will intelligently anticipate the services needs that we'll have based on who you are, where you are, and what your preferences are. Transforming physical and analog content into digital formats. In fact, this is a central challenge faced by the communications and media industries as they try to monetize their assets over the internet. We are developing new smart computing devices, networks, and architecture that are first secure and operate at internet speeds and scale.
Well, thanks for that ovation. hardly believe all that enthusiasm. Welcome to Hewlett-Packard. I can't see you very well, but I'm thrilled you're here. It's a great place to be. For those of you that have followed the company in HP Labs, you know this group has been the source of tremendous innovation in the company. PA Risk, Thermal Inkjet, Dynamic Smart Cooling. It's one of the places where there's still real R left in R&D. Most of the R&D in the world today is D. And we've got a commitment to the org. Thanks for coming to this. Thanks for spending time at HP. I'm going to introduce Shane Robeson, our Chief Technology Officer, who has responsibility for the labs, amongst other things, at HP.
Yeah, we can talk about Web 2.0, 3.0, 4.0. It's a little bit hard, depending on who you talk to determine what that means, or wikis or blogs. I'm not going to do that. What I want to do is talk more about what are the implications of all the changes that we see happening. Today, I think we'd all agree that with broadband being very pervasive and internet as a platform being very pervasive, cloud computing's really taken off, and it is ready for prime time, and there's a lot that both consumers and businesses can do with it. In the past, we've had a web of static pages. Today, we have a web of dynamic services. Pretty subtle but fundamental change in the infrastructure for the internet. So we're now entering what I like to call the era of everything as a service. So I don't say software as a service or service-oriented architectures. Those are all tools and foundational building blocks. What we're really doing is presenting our technologies and our capabilities as services or through services to either businesses, for entertainment, for personal uses, to community, and they're all much richer and much more personalized. Software as a service and presenting everything as a service it may seem like it's old news, but we're just getting started. And the analogy I like to use is when I was in the PC industry, which was quite a while ago, once the PC platform was established as a standard, and software developers could assume that that platform was pervasive and that they could target it with exciting applications, we experienced a decade of new software development. It was incredible, the explosion of creative ideas that were all targeted at that platform. And we've laid out a few of the logos from companies that are currently out there doing this. And these are just the public companies. These are not people, it doesn't necessarily include people who are developing web services capabilities that are inside their companies that they're using to communicate with whichever constituency they care about, employees, customers, suppliers, partners, sometimes even competitors. And if you think about it, again, there's a lot going on already, but we're just getting started. What's missing is a seamless user experience across multiple devices. A lot of times I get the question about when are you going to build a Swiss Army knife so we have one device that does everything. The real question, or I flip that on its head, the right question in my mind is, how do we ensure that for all the different devices we use, we have a consistent interface to the services that we care about? Content's going to sit in the cloud, so the real version of your content will sit somewhere in the cloud. And devices are fungible. It's really about the service. Crowdsourcing is going mainstream, and this is going to change the rules of the game forever. So what crowdsourcing really is using internet and internet services to access the collective knowledge of a community. Business intelligence is not going to just be for top execs anymore.